We meet as God's people in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Welcome to our online service here at St Laurence Church in Winslow. We're delighted that you have joined us for this worship. This morning I shall be leading our worship today. Just a quick reminder of our church fundraising 25-mile walk this Friday, the 21st of August. Please do join us for all or part of it. And if you'd like to know more about it, please email the church office, whose details will be at the end of this service. And if you can, please sponsor the walkers on our Just Giving page. We continue in our summer series on saints and inspirational people. And today we look to Mary, the mother of Jesus. And I shall be talking in my sermon a bit about her humility, but about the Blessed Virgin Mary. Mary was a young Jewish girl living in Nazareth when a messenger from the Lord announced that she was to be the bearer of the Son of God to the world. Her response, "Let it be to me according to your word." It revealed her natural sense of obedience to God and her reverence for his word, showing her worthy to be the bearer of the word made flesh. This day is now celebrated as the major feast of the Blessed Virgin Mary throughout most of Christendom. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We have done what was wrong in the Lord's sight and chosen what has displeased him. Yet, as a mother comforts her child, so shall the Lord himself comfort us. So let us come to him, who knows our every deed and thought. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, and confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, who looked upon the lowliness of the Blessed Virgin Mary and chose her to be the mother of your only Son, grant that we who are redeemed by his blood may share with her in the glory of your eternal kingdom, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord, my whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, for he has looked with favour on the lowliness of his servant. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. Mary said, my soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, for he has looked with favour on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed. For the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever. This is the gospel of Christ. I pray that I may speak in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. In a couple of days, two people shall stand here in this church and promise each other that they will take one another as their spouse, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death parts them. They will do all of this according to God's holy law. These marriage vows are beautiful, but they are huge. Don't let the poetry of the words lull you, for they are massive in their scale of commitment and take the promisors a lifetime to fulfill. And when I think back to the time when I made those same promises to my wife, I couldn't foresee the demands that they would make. That's not because I was ill-prepared by the poor priest who married us both, but that simply life gets in the way of our plans. It turns out quite different to that which we expect, and we have to adjust. And that doesn't stop as my wife and I near our 10th wedding anniversary. Maybe all we can say is that we have adjusted so far, and I hope our love is strong enough to bind us as we negotiate the next decade, and so on and so on. Mary promises to God's messenger to let it be according to God's word. And it is similarly huge in the scale of its commitment. I can't believe this young girl, for I doubt very much that nowadays we would be describing anyone of such tender age as a woman. As I say, I can't believe she would have understood quite what she was being asked. No one could have. The joys and the excitement, but also the disappointment and the devastation of bringing into the world and caring for and loving her son, who was to be the saviour of that world, whose redemption would see him crucified in front of her. And as with marriage, in fulfilling her vow, Mary would have led quite a different life to that which she might have expected or indeed have planned. To have been able to respond to the challenges and the calling of God, as well as resisting the temptations to fall away, all done in an effort to meet God's word. And what we see in Mary is what I will also recommend to the couple on Saturday, beginning their new life together. And that is humility. A willingness not to think that we have all of the answers, that what we know and think is the end of the matter, but that we have the ability to hear and to learn, not to rank our opinions and views so highly that we don't hear anybody else. Put simply, to have the humility to shut up and listen. To have the humility to allow our minds to be changed. To have the humility to have wills that are pliable. To have the humility to have hearts that are soft. This is not weakness, for genuine humility is a strength which enables us to attend to listen to others, and of course to God. Humility creates that space in which the miracle of love can happen. For in that moment, the world stops revolving around me and our vision can be enlarged to see and hear the other and to take them seriously. In relationship, it is something everyone does, both giving, both supporting. Humility, then, is the way that we begin to meet the commandment to love God and to love each other. In our humility, we prefer the other to ourselves. And as I shall say to my bride and groom, when we love like that, when we love someone else more than we love ourselves, then we have truly found the holiest part of ourselves. For such love is how God loves. May Mary's promise to let it be, inspire us to be humble, wherever we are, whatever our own situation. Let us be humble enough to listen to each other, to learn from each other, and to love one another. Amen. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we pray to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we say with Mary, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your prophet of old foretold a day when a virgin would conceive and bear a son who would be called God with us. Help us to look forward to your deliverance and to seek the fullness of your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Your angel declared to Mary that she was to be the mother of the Saviour. Help every Christian person to be open to your word and obedient to your will. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Mary rejoiced with Elizabeth and sang your praise. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. Help us to live joyful lives that sing of your praise. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Mary bore a son of David's line, a king whose reign would never end. Bless all the nations of with Christ's gift of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The child Jesus grew in wisdom and stature in the home of Mary and Joseph. Strengthen our own homes and families and keep under your protection all those whom we love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. At the foot of the cross of Christ stood his mother, and from the cross she received his lifeless body in her arms. Give comfort and healing to all. And we pray particularly from our own community, Mary Claire, Roy, Tim, Storm, Carolyn, Nigel and Lisa, Heather, Ethan, Anne and Alan, Michael, Penny, all those that are associated with and live in Swan House. For Harry, Isabel, Carol, Jeannie, Grace and family, Becky, Alison and Joshua. Comfort all who suffer and all who watch the suffering of those that they love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The Apostle John saw a vision of a woman in heaven, robed with the sun. Bring us, with Russell Long and Sophia Clark, and all those who have died in the face of Christ, to share the joy of heaven with Mary and all the saints. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty and everlasting God, your handmaid Mary magnified your name and rejoiced in your saving love. Trusting in that same love, we ask all these our prayers through Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and his name shall be called the Prince of Peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. God our Father, your handmaid Mary fed your Son at her virgin breast. Nourish us at this table with the bread of heaven and the cup of salvation. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right and our joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. For he is your living word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born of a woman and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forevermore praising you and singing. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take. Eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it. In remembrance of me. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body because we all share in the one bread. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. The body of Christ, broken for us. The blood of Christ, shed for us. Let us pray. God Most High, whose handmaid bore the Word made flesh, we thank you that in this sacrament of our redemption, you visit us with your Holy Spirit and overshadow us by your power. Strengthen us to walk with Mary the joyful and humble path of obedience, and so to bring forth the fruits of holiness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Christ, the Son of God, born of Mary, fill you with his grace to trust his promises and obey his will. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.